to follow Jesus. I have decided to follow Jesus.
Amen. So, I'm just going to speak to us just for 10 minutes. Amen. And we'll be done. Amen.
Amen.
Yes, and the one that I'm going to share with us is, which report are you going to believe? Which report shall you believe? Amen?
Amen.
Yes, and as you know, in the time that you are living, we always receive different kind of reports from doctors, from our friends, from circumstances, from all areas. We are always receiving reports. Amen? And we have to choose which kind of report we are going to believe. Amen?
Amen.
And I need to open our Bibles in the book of 2 Chronicles, chapter 20. 2 Chronicles. Amen. Yeah, you can read it maybe at home. I'll just explain it. 2 Chronicles chapter 20. Amen. Yes, the Bible here is talking about Jehoshaphat. And here Jehoshaphat, he received a report that they were going to be attacked. Amen.
Amen.
In other words, he received a report of threat. He received a negative report, in other words. Amen?
Amen.
But we see Jehoshaphat, maybe he could have begun maybe to cry. He could have begun maybe to get anxious. He could have chosen to maybe to just run away. He could have chosen to do different things. But we see he chose to do what is wise. And the Bible says he resolved to inquire of the Lord. Amen. And when you continue reading the chapter, they sought the face of God, they prayed, and God gave a word that they are going to see the deliverance. And as you read the end of the chapter, all the enemies were destroyed. Amen? And the Bible says they experienced peace. After that, the land experienced great peace. Amen?
Amen.
So here in this story, we get to see, like Jehoshaphat, he received a report. He was a servant of God. But also, of being a servant of God, he received a negative report. And he had to make a choice, whether to believe in the report, or maybe to choose to inquire from the Lord. But glory be to God, because he inquired of the Lord, and God gave him victory. Amen?
Amen.
And this shows also in our lives, we receive different kinds of reports. Maybe in the past, you received a report. Amen? Or maybe yesterday you received a report. But the question is, which kind of report are you going to believe? And the reason why Jehoshaphat, he chose to seek the face of God, I believe because he wanted to believe that report. And the answer he received from God, that they are going to see the deliverance, he believed God. And you know what happened from verse 20? The Bible says, they began to sing and to praise God. Even before they had seen the miracle, they began singing and praising God. When you read verse 20 to 22, amen? And the Bible says, when they began to sing and to praise God, even they did not need to fight the fight. The Bible says the enemy destroyed themselves. The enemy killed one another, amen? And God gave them great peace and even great wealth in the land in Jesus' mighty name, amen? And this is the same question the Lord is asking you tonight. Which report are you going to believe? Maybe someone there in the past, he told you maybe you never become anything in life. And you know, sometimes people, they say they have not believed it. As you find maybe inside, they believe the report. Maybe even if it's a little bit. That a little bit also is bad. We should choose to believe only the report of God. Amen. And we know what the report of God says. It is written in His Word. His report says, we are more than conquerors. His report says, we can do all things through Christ who strengthens us. His report says, there is no condemnation for those who are in Christ Jesus. Amen. Amen. His report, he says, by the stripes of the Lord Jesus Christ, we are healed. Amen. His report, he says, let the weak say, I am strong. Let the poor say, I am rich. Amen. Amen. That is the report of God. I don't know which report you have received in your life. Maybe yesterday, maybe in the past. It might have become an obstacle in your life. But today the Lord is telling that you should choose to believe only the report of God. And the report of God is going to give you victory. The report of God is going to birth in you joy. Even as you wait for the miracle or you wait for the promise of God. Amen. Because we see, when Jehoshaphat sought the face of God, he received a word from God that everything was going to be okay, that everything was going to be victorious. And after that, they did not continue with the spirit of mourning. They entered in the spirit of praise. They entered in the spirit of singing unto the Lord. And the Bible says it's when they began to do that, that the Lord brought the miracle to manifestation. And that was deliverance from the enemies. Amen? Amen. And that is the same thing in our life. Sometimes we receive report. Some people choose to cry. Others choose maybe to feel, to have low self-esteem. Others choose to feel it differently. But you know, that's not the will of God. The will of God is that in any report you receive, first, we should inquire of the Lord. And when we inquire of the Lord, He'll always give us a word. And we should stand on that word. Amen? Amen. And even when you receive the word, even before you see the manifestation of the answer that you are believing God for, you should begin to praise Him. You should begin to worship Him. You should begin to glorify Him. And you will see the manifestation of the miracle in Jesus' mighty name. Amen? Amen. So as we walk in our lives, as we continue to pursue our destinies, every day you should ask yourself, this day I'm walking, which report am I going to believe? Maybe my teacher said I can never maybe solve this question. Are you going to believe that report? But you know the report of the Lord says, you are heirs, never tell. Amen? Which report are you going to believe? And even sometimes you can receive a negative report from even the people you don't expect. And some people, they get brokenhearted. How could he say like that? How could she say like that? Yes, it's only him who said that. But what is the report of God saying? Because what the report of God is saying, that is final. And if we believe that report, we still get the results of what the report promises. Amen? Amen. And again, when you read the book of 1 Chronicles chapter 4, verse 10, verse 9 and 10, you remember there was a man, he was called Jabez. Amen? And the Bible says, when he was born, his mother gave him the name Jabez, meaning pain. Amen? Amen. But the Bible says Jabez chose to seek the face of God. Amen? And he told God, Lord, I want you to expand my territories. Lord, I want you to keep me away from evil and pain. Amen? Lord, I want you to bless me indeed. And the Bible says God granted his request. You see, even his own mother had given him a wrong name, meaning pain. But he chose not to believe that. He chose to go an extra mile. He sought the face of God, and God gave him the desires of his heart. In other words, God gave him a new name, a name of victory. Amen? He expanded his territories. I don't know, maybe the names you have been given. Maybe situation has given you names. Maybe people have given you names. Maybe different things you went in the past, they have given you a name. Are you going to believe in that report? Or you are going to renew your mind and believe in the report of God? And if you believe in the report of God and you inquire of God, as the way the Lord granted the desire of Jabez and He gave him a new name, in the same way the Lord is going to do in your life in Jesus' mighty name. Amen? Because the God that we serve is the same yesterday, today, and forevermore in Jesus' mighty name. Amen. And He is committed to see that His report is fulfilled in our lives. But the question is, are we willing to believe in that report? You know, the Bible says, everything is possible to whoever who believes. And it means even when we believe the report of God, that report is possible to happen. Amen. And you know we are serving a God who is able to do immeasurable, even above all that we ask, above all that we require from Him. Amen.
Amen.
And you know, when you get to know this, we can be able to live every day full of joy, full of divine strength, full of hope for the future. Because we know the report of God brings life. The report of God will bring victory. The report of God will bring fulfillment. Amen. Amen.
Amen.
And also, when you are working, you should remember always, the enemy, as long as you want to grow, as long as you want to move in higher places, the enemy will always try to whisper some things. The enemy will always try to speak some things. But it's up to you and me to choose whether we are going to believe them. Amen?
Amen.
And you know, I believe one thing that has hindered a lot of people from growing, maybe from milk to eating meat, from growing spiritually, from growing financially, academically, in all other areas, it is not the report they have chosen to believe. They had a report, and maybe over the time, they have chosen to believe the report. And it has given them retarded growth. Instead of growing forward, they have been growing backward, or they have become stagnant. But if you have believed such kind of a report, today is the day to tell the Lord, God, I'm no longer going to believe this report. I'm going to believe your report. Your report that it brings life. Your report that it brings victory. In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
And as you begin to believe this report and you pray to God, you begin to praise Him. You begin to dance for Him. Because you know that report is going to be realized in Jesus' mighty name.
Amen.
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 And you know, these things happen as we are growing in our lives, in our families, in our society. Because the world is full of different things. But we have to choose to believe the right report and see the glory of God. Amen?
Amen?
Because nowadays some people are walking in anger. Others are walking in revenge. Because of the report they chose to believe. But if you choose to believe the report of God, we will always walk in forgiveness. We'll be able to walk in joy. We'll be able to operate in victory. We'll be able to operate in serving God and serving His people in Jesus' mighty name. Because also there are people who are saying, okay, I'll never be serving people anymore. Because somebody said something somewhere. And they say, okay, Lord, if I do this thing and they say like this, then I'll not be serving anymore. In other words, they chose to believe a wrong report. They forgot the report of God. Amen?
Amen.
So let's choose to believe the report of God. And you will see ourselves being able to grow from glory to glory. And one thing that I've seen, any time that you desire to grow, any time that you set your mind now, I want to grow in God, I want to grow in His Word, I want to grow in my academics, some reports always begin to come to pull you back to where, and somebody wonder, I set a resolution, but what happened? Because when you set a resolution, that resolution has to be tested by reports. Reports are sent, signals are sent. And you have to choose to go through them and see the fulfillment of the resolution we set in Jesus' mighty name. Amen?
Amen.
So just begin to think, the resolution you set in the beginning of the year. We are almost in a quarter of the year. Quarter of the year is almost gone. Amen? Are you still believing in those resolutions God gave you? Or along the way, because of the things, the way they have been working, you have chosen to believe a wrong report. But I encourage you to believe the report of God. And where you have doubts, where you don't see it clear, I encourage you to inquire from God. And yes, you inquire from God. Our God is faithful. He says when we ask anything in His name, He will do it unto us, that our joy might be made complete, and that He may receive glory. Amen. He is committed to answering our prayers. In other words, even He loves answering our prayers. And that's why whenever we inquire from Him, even before we see the manifestation, we can begin to dance in faith. We can begin to praise Him for the miracle. Because we know the miracle is going to come In Jesus' mighty name.
Amen.
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 So let's choose to believe the radio report. Jabez chose to believe the radio report, and he received a miracle. And through this way, even we'll be able to grow greatly. Because there are some people who have been limited. They grow up, they grow down. Grow, grow down, grow. In other words, they are stagnant. Because any time they desire to grow, a report comes, and they choose to believe a wrong report. They stop praying, they stop studying the word of God again, they lose the enthusiasm, they lose the passion of going to church, they lose the passion of studying, they lose the passion, maybe go get a divorce and you have been studying all the night. They lose the passion of studying, no, it's not possible. Getting a divorce is not a destiny, it just shows us where to begin. That is where to begin, it's not where you are ending, it's just the beginning. You know that now you are in two, you can jump to four. Amen?
Amen.
Because getting a 2-1, it doesn't mean that's your end. It just means it's your beginning. It just shows you where to begin, not where you are ending. Yeah, amen. Go through all manner of things from the forest, from people in different areas. Even people will tell you, like, maybe you are not going anywhere. Why are you putting so much effort in books? You don't have money, how are you going to study and all those kind of things? And I remember when I was in primary school, and people would say, no, this primary school, people don't go anywhere, they don't pass, so you should relax, man. Amen.
Yeah.
But I told God, that time because I was born again, and I had studied the word of God, and I knew one scripture, the Bible says, I can do all things through Christ who gives me strength. And you know, this one verse was able to give me victory in all my primary school and higher school. Because I knew, yes, things have been happening like this. But the Lord tells me I can do still all things through Him who gives me strength. Amen? And in the midst of all circumstances, in the midst of all challenges, God was able still to give me great success. I remember the time I was doing I was finishing high school, and I was supposed to begin an exam tomorrow. And that day, my cousin, like, he was staying with us, he got sick, he was to be taken to the hospital. So I was left home with a servant. I'm going to begin the exam tomorrow. The next morning, when I went for exam, the servant, his leg was cut by a plow while digging. Then it means I had to do exams. And at the same time, I have to look after cattle and goats and everything. Amen? And you know, because my dad said now, the way things are going, he was expecting me to fail. Because things were very difficult. But at the same time, my Lord, because the challenges, they seem too big, it means my miracle is going to be great. It means it's the time of my victory. And I told God, just give me peace to be able to go through this exam successfully. I was at home alone. I did the exam, and I was able to get distinction by God's grace. Amen?
Amen.
Even my parents were surprised. How was it possible? The only thing I could tell them is because of Him. Because I chose not to believe in the report of what's happening. I chose to believe in the higher report. And the higher report says, even when I go through fire, when we go through anything, through waters, He will always be with us. And He will always do a new thing in our lives in Jesus' mighty name.
Amen.
And maybe tonight you might be going through different things. It might be in your thoughts. It might be in your spiritual life. It might be in your family. I encourage you to believe in the report of God. And even in the midst of those circumstances, begin to dance for the Lord. Begin to praise Him. Begin to glorify His holy name. Because great is your miracle. Great is the fulfillment of the promise of God in your life in Jesus' mighty name.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. So, as I finish, as you go home, keep asking yourself, which report have I been believing? Really, have I been believing the right report? Or have I been believing the report of God? Click believing in the report of God and delete believing the report of the enemy. Amen?
Amen.
And you see the glory of God in your life, and through your life, to the people that God brings into you. In Jesus' mighty name. Amen. I know that God is committed to give you victory. He's committed to give you divine destiny. As long as you're willing to believe in His report. To believe in what He has told you concerning your life in Jesus' mighty name. We don't need to feel pity about ourselves. We don't need to feel bad about ourselves. We don't need to have lower esteem. No, that's not the will of God. We don't need to have fear in our lives. Because we serve the King of Kings. And He has given us the best report by sending the Lord Jesus Christ dying on the cross. He paid everything that we may be able to believe in His report and that His report might be fulfilled in our lives in Jesus' mighty name. So you have a reason to rejoice. You have a reason to be happy every day. You have a reason to pursue your destiny with confidence because greater is the one who is in you than the one who is in the world. In Jesus' mighty name. Amen. So God bless you so much. Amen. As you continue to believe in the reward of God. Amen. 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 So God bless you.